What is up, guys? Jimmy, your Chaos Silencer. Welcome back to the You Pick My Class series for Black Ops 2, where you guys in the comment section pick a crazy class, and I do the best I can to get the best gameplay I can with it. And up on the screen now from Alec Bogosh was the LSAT with any attachments, the SMAW, the Bouncing Betty, the Sensor Grenade, Lightweight, Hardwired, and Awareness. And apparently I could use whatever score streaks I wanted, so I believe I used the Lightning Strike, the Hellstorm Missile, and the UAV. My attachments, I want to say I went with two or three attachments on this thing. I'm not for sure. I know I've got the Reflex, and I also have a foregrip on it. So, let's talk about this class. I did a video about how to combat head glitchers with this class, because using this thing, putting a dot on it, and being able to pick off people from behind cover is pretty easy, because there's not a lot of recoil, especially if you're going to throw on a foregrip. It gives you even more accuracy with this thing. So with that being said, it's good, but here's the issue that I had with it. For one, mobility. I'm playing with a party of dudes, Minnesota Burns and some other guys, and we're down at the beginning, but I think we come back to take the lead. But there's a valuable lesson at the end of this video, which I'll get to in a little while. But my lack of mobility really made it to me where it felt like the gameplay was campish and sluggish at times. I found myself ADSing and head glitching myself, which I know head glitching is just a term that the community use. Actually, it's called taking cover and getting the advantage in a firefight, which there's absolutely nothing wrong with. It's the head glitchers that sit there for 4 minutes at a time and don't move, and they just ADS and wait, completely wait there. But I did find myself from times kind of sticking to one area and ADSing a lot and kind of waiting for the enemy to come to me, and that's not my usual type of gameplay, so it kind of took me out of my comfort zone, to be honest with you. I did good. I think I went like 47-8, got a couple lightning strikes. There's a 5-man or 6-man lightning strike right there. Got some good hail storms, and the UAV obviously helped me out, but I really don't like the fact that it hinders my movement around the map. I'd rather run around with some lightweight on and an SMG or an assault rifle or something like that to where I can get from point A to point B, especially when I need to help. And I'll explain at the end of this video why I would have been better served with the faster class at the end of the video. So we come back, we take the lead, we're in round two now, and we actually get a little bit of a cushion on the lead, so I kind of get comfortable and lackadaisical with this thing, and I'm just going around trying to get kills. I'll admit it, I was trying to kill whore a little bit and get you guys a good gameplay with it. I'm running the little blue custom reticle on it, the dot, which I really liked. It was really easy to pinpoint on, guys. You can spray and pray with this thing with the best of them. I mean, they're going to run out of bullets before you run out of bullets if you guys start doing the dance of death with each other. There's no way that you can lose if you can keep any bullets on target with this, as you see while I'm sitting here in the room. But, for instance, I'm in this room, I'm not very mobile, and it almost comes off as campish to a degree. Not to mention that it takes me almost 8 seconds to fully reload this gun. So I have to back out of a firefight or get into cover with a firefight to even reload this gun. And there's numerous times in this, not this match, but trying to get you guys a gameplay and doing that head glitching video where I had to back out of a fight to reload, and I got killed because I was focused on reloading. So that's another negative. On the positive, this thing, if you're playing with a party of guys and they need somebody to throw down suppressor fire or to suppress the enemy or keep them back off a flag, this is the weapon of choice. If you're not used to moving around a lot and you're not worried about not being mobile, then this gun's going to be good for you. It's going to be a good fit for you. Me, it just took me out of my comfort zone to a degree, and you can see. So we go down here. It's a close match. Close match. And it takes me a minute to realize, hey, you probably need to get on and move around and try to create some diversions for your teammates to capture a couple flags. So I get a couple kill streaks. That does okay. But it comes down to it, and at the end of the match, we actually get down and we can't get the B flag quick enough to get back in this. And I really had this. If you've played with me before, you've seen me play, you know I'm definitely a team player, objective player. I'm a teammate, a good teammate, I like to think. But on this one, I felt hindered when it came down to crunch time, which is right about right here, 161 to 161, and I needed to get going and help my guys get some flags, and I didn't feel like I could do that with this thing. I really didn't. I felt kind of hindered to a degree. That may be an excuse. I don't know. I'm just telling you guys the feeling I got while I was in game. I tried to take out people. I got frustrated at the very end, and I wasn't able to be one of the dudes to help us bring it back. So we ended up losing this match. And the reason I'm showing that is to let you know, don't ever get comfortable in a match. Even if you're doing great, because somebody, they can come and sideswipe you and take it at the very end. And I think it was partially my fault. I take ownership in the reason we lost that match. So there you go, guys. In the comment section, you pick the next crazy class you want to see, and I'll rock it out. I'll pick a popular one from Thumbs Up, and we'll do this again. That's it. I'm out. Be sure to rate and comment.